Cervical spondylosis. Overview. Cervical means our neck area. Spondylosis means a degenerative condition affecting our spine. Our neck consists of these parts. A. Bones. Your neck is a part of the spine, which makes up the top 7 out of 24 bones, called vertebrae, that are stacked on top of one another. The shape of these bones creates a hollow part that protects the spinal cord. B. Spinal cord and nerves. These wires go through the spinal canal to send signals between your brain and other parts of the body. From the spinal cord, the nerve roots rise out through openings in the vertebrae or foramen. C. Joints. There are 3 joints between each pair of vertebrae. The joint in the front is the intervertebral disc, which are the flexible pillows filled with jelly. They help to absorb the shock when you walk or run. The 2 joints in the back are the facet joints. There is a cartilage in each joint to cushion the ends of the bones. There are also ligaments, the soft bands of tissue to bind and strengthen the vertebrae together. Cervical spondylosis is the natural wearing down of these parts of the neck as we age. These changes happen in everyone as they are normal. More than half of middle-aged people and older have worn down discs that may not cause noticeable symptoms. These weariness can include dehydrated discs. By the age of 40, our spinal discs begin drying out and shrinking, resulting in loss of disc height, which risks more bone-on-bone contact between the vertebrae. Herniated discs. Herniated or bulging discs may appear from the crack. Bone spurs. These are grown in a misguided effort to strengthen the spine. Facet joint arthritis. It is caused by increased pressure and the degeneration process. Stiff ligaments. Spinal ligaments can stiffen as you grow older. Your neck will become less flexible. Risk factor. Age. The condition is common around 80% in patients who are 40 years and older. Occupation. Jobs that involve repetitive neck motions, awkward positioning, or a lot of overhead work put extra stress on your neck. Previous neck injuries. Genetic factors. Individuals in certain families with a history of neck pain will experience more of these changes over time. Smoking. The nicotine inside can affect the blood supply to your neck. Depression or anxiety. People with anxiety are prone to bad posture due to their negative moods. Being overweight and inactive. The added pressure can cause a strain in many parts of the spine, including the neck. Symptoms and alarming signs. For most people, cervical spondylosis shows no symptoms. When it does, the first ones typically are pain and stiffness in the neck. This pain may develop gradually or occur suddenly, and usually improves with rest or lying down. Other symptoms may include headaches, the sound of grind and pop when your neck is turned, muscle spasms in the neck and shoulders. If the symptoms do not go away after a few days, you could try to visit your doctor. However, if any of these alarming signs appear, then you must not wait. You have a tingling or numbness sensation in your hands, legs or feet, lack of coordination and difficulty in walking, loss of function of hands, like having problems in writing, loss of bladder or bowel control. The alarming signs may be the result of the pinch from your neck bones to the spinal cord, called cervical myelopathy, or to the nerve root, called cervical radiculopathy. It is also an urgent condition if you experience dizziness or blackout when turning your head or bending the neck, because it means the vertebrae artery, which supplies the brain, is affected by the degenerative change. Now, what is treatment available for your condition? You may need to undergo physical therapy or even surgery under certain circumstances. We'll explain more in the next part of this video.